This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Lido Anthony Lee Iacocca, Acock, I. Co-K, born October 15, 1924, is an American automobile executive best known for spearheading the development of Ford Mustang and Pinto cars, while at the Ford Motor Company in the 1960s, and then later for reviving the Chrysler Corporation as its CEO during the 1980s. He served as president and CEO of Chrysler from 1978 and additionally as chairman from 1979, until his retirement at the end of 1992. Iacocca was a passionate advocate of U.S. business exports during the 1980s. He is the author or co-author of several books, including Iacocca, an autobiography with William Novak, and Where Have All the Leaders Gone? Portfolio named Iacocca the 18th greatest American CEO of all time. Contents: 1. Early life. 2. Career at Ford. 21. Ford Pinto. 3. Career at Chrysler. 31. 1979 Chrysler bailout. 32. 1995 return to Chrysler. 33. Chrysler's 2009 bankruptcy. 4. Other work and activities. 41. Books. 42. Businesses. 43. Activism and philanthropy. 44. Acting. 5. Personal life. 51. Marriage and family. 52. Politics. 6. Awards. 7. See also. 8. References. 9. Bibliography. 91. Works by. 92. Works about. 10. External links. Early life. Iacocca was born in Allentown, Pennsylvania, to Nicola Iacocca and Antonietta Parada, Italian immigrants from San Marco dei Cavati, Benevento, who had settled in Pennsylvania's steel production belt. They operated a restaurant, Yakko's Hot Dogs. He was said to have been christened with the unusual name Lido because he was conceived during his parents' honeymoon in the Lido district in Venice. However, he refutes this rumor in his autobiography, saying that is romantic but not true. His father went to Lido long before his marriage and was traveling with his future wife's brother. Iacocca graduated from Allentown High School, now known as William Allen High School, in 1942, and Lehigh University in neighboring Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. With a degree in industrial engineering. He is a member of Tau Beta Pi, the Engineering Honor Society, and an alumnus of Theta Chi fraternity. After graduating from Lehigh, he won the Wallace Memorial Fellowship and went to Princeton University, where he took his electives in politics and plastics. He then began a career at the Ford Motor Company as an engineer. Career at Ford. Iacocca was instrumental in the introduction of the Ford Mustang. Pictured here is a 1964.5 Mustang convertible. Iacocca joined Ford Motor Company in August 1946 after a brief stint in engineering. He asked to be moved to sales and marketing, where his career flourished while working in the Philadelphia district as assistant sales manager. Iacocca gained national recognition with his 56 for 56 campaign, offering loans on 1956 model year cars with a 20% down payment and $56 in monthly payments for 3 years. His campaign went national, and Iacocca was called to Dearborn, where he quickly moved up through the ranks. On November 10, 1960, Iacocca was named vice president and general manager of the Ford division. In January 1965, Ford's vice president, car and truck group. In 1967, executive vice president, and president. On December 10, 1970, Iacocca participated in the design of several successful Ford automobiles, most notably the Ford Mustang, the Lincoln Continental Mark III, the Ford Escort, and the revival of the Mercury brand in the late 1960s, including the introduction of the Mercury Cougar and Mercury Marquis. He promoted other ideas which did not reach the marketplace as Ford products. These included cars ultimately introduced by Chrysler, the K car, and the minivan. Eventually, he became the president of the Ford Motor Company, but he clashed with Henry Ford II. He was fired on July 13, 1978, despite the fact that the company posted a $2 billion profit for the year. Ford Pinto. Main article, Ford Pinto. In 1968, Iacocca foresaw the need for domestically produced, small, fuel-efficient vehicles, and proposed a vehicle that weighed less than 2,000 pounds and would be priced at less than $2,000. Although Ford's European subsidiary was already selling such a model named Escort, a team of Ford designers was assigned to create the exterior and interior of an entirely new car, which would be named Pinto. The Pinto entered production beginning with the 1971 model year. Iacocca was described as the moving force behind the Ford Pinto in 1977. There were allegations that the Pinto's structural design allowed its fuel tank filler neck to break off and the fuel tank to be punctured in a rear-end collision, resulting in deadly fires. This case is a staple of engineering ethics courses as an example of a bad cost-benefit analysis. In 1978, all 1971 to 1977 76 Pintos were recalled and had safety shielding and reinforcements installed to protect the fuel tank. Career at Chrysler Iacocca was strongly courted by the Chrysler Corporation, at a time when the company appeared to be on the verge of going out of business and had just sold its loss-making Chrysler Europe division to Peugeot in an effort to generate cash because the company was losing millions already in North America. This was largely due to recalls of its Dodge Aspen and Plymouth Volare, both of which Iacocca later said should never have been built. Dubious. Discuss. Iacocca joined Chrysler and began rebuilding the entire company from the ground up, laying off many workers, and bringing in many former associates from his former company, also from Ford. Iacocca brought to Chrysler the Mini Max project, which, in 1983, bore fruit in the highly successful Dodge Caravan and Plymouth Voyager. Henry Ford II had wanted nothing to do with the Mini Max, a restyled version of the minivan, which Toyota was selling in huge numbers in Asia and Latin America, and his opinion doomed the project at Ford. Hal Spurlick, the driving force behind the Mini Max at Ford, had been fired a few months before Iacocca. He had been hired by Chrysler, where the two would make automotive history. Iacocca arrived shortly after Chrysler's introduction of the subcompact Dodge Omni and Plymouth Horizon, bearing a strong resemblance to the Volkswagen Rabbit. The front-wheel drive Omni and Horizon became instant hits, selling over 300,000 units each in their debut year, showing what was to come for Chrysler. The Omni had been designed alongside the Chrysler Horizon with much input from the Chrysler Europe division of the company, evidenced by many examples having VW, Audi engines, which Iacocca axed in 1978-1979. Chrysler bailout. The Dodge Aries, a typical K car, realizing that the company would go out of business if it did not receive a large infusion of cash, Iacocca approached the United States Congress in 1979 and successfully requested a loan guarantee in order to obtain the guarantee. Chrysler was required to reduce costs and abandon some long-standing projects, such as the turbine engine, which had been ready for consumer production in 1979. After nearly 20 years of development, Chrysler released the first of the K-car line, the Dodge Aries and Plymouth Reliant, in 1981. Similar to the later minivan, these compact automobiles were based on design proposals that Ford had rejected during Iacocca's and Spurlick's tenure. Released in the middle of the major 1980-1982 recession, the small, efficient, and inexpensive front-wheel drive cars sold rapidly. In addition, Iacocca reintroduced the big Imperial as the company's flagship. The new model had all of the newest technologies of the time, including fully electronic fuel injection and all-digital dashboard. Chrysler introduced the minivan, chiefly Spurlick's baby. In the fall of 1983, it led the automobile industry in sales for 25 years because of the K cars and minivans, along with the reforms Iacocca implemented. The company turned around quickly and was able to repay the government-backed loans 7 years earlier than expected. The Jeep Grand Cherokee design was the driving force behind Chrysler's buyout of AMC. Iacocca desperately wanted it. Iacocca led Chrysler's acquisition of AMC in 1987, which brought the profitable Jeep division under the corporate umbrella. It created the short-lived Eagle division, formed from the remnants of AMC. By this time, AMC had already finished most of the work on the Jeep Grand Cherokee, which Iacocca wanted. The Grand Cherokee would not be released until 1992 for the 1993 model year, the same year that Iacocca retired. Throughout the 1980s, Iacocca appeared in a series of commercials for the company's vehicles, employing the ad campaign, "The Pride Is Back," to denote the turnaround of the corporation. He also voiced what was to become his trademark phrase, "If you can find a better car, buy it." Iacocca retired as president, CEO and chairman of Chrysler at the end of 1992-1995. Return to Chrysler in 1995, Iacocca assisted in billionaire Kirk Kerkorian's hostile takeover of Chrysler, which was ultimately unsuccessful the next year. Kerkorian and Chrysler made a five-year agreement which included a gag order preventing Iacocca from speaking publicly about Chrysler. In July 2005, Iacocca returned to the airwaves as Chrysler's pitchman, along with celebrities such as Jason Alexander and Snoop Dogg, to promote Chrysler's Employee Pricing Plus program. The ads reprise the "If you can find a better car, buy it" line, Iacocca's trademark of the 1980s. In return for his services, Iacocca and Daimler Chrysler agreed that his fees, plus a $1 donation per vehicle sold from July 1 through December 31, 2005, would be donated to the Iacocca Foundation for Diabetes Research. Chrysler's 2009 bankruptcy. In an April 2009 Newsweek interview, Iacocca reflected on his time spent at Chrysler and the company's current situation. He said, "This is a sad day for me. It pains me to see my old company, which has meant so much to America, on the ropes, but Chrysler has been in trouble before, and we got through it, and I believe they can do it again if they're smart. They'll bring together a consortium of workers, plant managers and dealers to come up with real solutions. These are the folks on the front lines, and they're the key to survival. Let's face it, if your car breaks down, you're not going to take it to the White House to get fixed, but if your company breaks down, you've got to go to the experts on the ground, not the bureaucrats. Every day I talk to dealers and managers, who are passionate and full of ideas. No one wants Chrysler to survive more than they do, so I'd say to the Obama administration, don't leave them out. Put their passion and ideas to work. Because of the Chrysler bankruptcy, Iacocca may lose part of his pension from a supplemental executive retirement plan and a guaranteed company car during his lifetime. The losses were due to take place once the bankruptcy court approves the sale of Chrysler to Chrysler Group LLC, with ownership of the new company by the United Auto Workers, the Italian carmaker Fiat, and the governments of the United States and Canada. Other work and activities. Books. In 1984, Iacocca co-authored with William Novak an autobiography, titled Iacocca, an autobiography. It was the best-selling non-fiction hardback book of 1984 and 1985. He donated the proceeds of the book's sales to diabetes research. In 1988, Iacocca co-authored with Sonny Kleinfeld Talking Straight, a book meant as a counterbalance to Akio Morita's Made in Japan, a non-fiction book praising Japan's post-war hard-working culture. Talking Straight praised the innovation and creativity of Americans. On May 17, 2007, Simon started a merchant bank to fund ventures in the gaming industry, which he called the fastest-growing business in the world. In 1995, he sold his interests in several Indian gaming projects to Full House Resorts, a casino operator led by his friend Alan Paulson, becoming a major shareholder and later a member of the board of directors. Iacocca joined the board of restaurant chain Cuckoo Roo in 1995. In 1998, he stepped up to serve as acting chairman of the troubled company, and led it through a merger with Family Restaurants owner of Chi Chi's and El Torito. He sat on the board of the merged company until stepping down in 1999. In 1999, Iacocca became the head of EV Global Motors, a company formed to develop and market electric bikes with a top speed of 15. Manufactures the Olivio line of food products made from olive oil. He donates all profits from the company to diabetes research. In 2004, Iacocca launched Join Lee Now, a national grassroots campaign to bring Faustman's research to human clinical trials. In 2006, Iacocca has been an advocate of Nourish the Children, an initiative of New Skin Enterprises. Since its inception in 2002, he is currently its chairman. He helped donate a generator for the Malawi Vitamil plant. Iacocca led the fundraising campaign to enable Lehigh University to adapt and use vacant buildings formerly owned by Bethlehem Steel. Iacocca Hall on the mountaintop campus of Lehigh University houses the College of Education, the Biology and Chemical Engineering departments, and the Iacocca Institute, which is focused on global competitiveness. Acting Iacocca played Park Commissioner Leto in Sons and Lovers, the 44th episode of Miami Vice, which premiered on May 9, 1986. The name of the character is his birth name, which was not used in the public sphere due to the trouble of mispronunciation or misspelling. Personal life, marriage and family. Iacocca was married to Mary McCleary on September 29, 1956. They had two daughters, Catherine and Leah. Mary Iacocca died on May 15, 1983 from diabetes both before and after her death. Iacocca became a strong advocate for better medical treatment of diabetes patients, who frequently faced debilitating and fatal complications. Iacocca's second marriage was to Peggy Johnson. They married on April 17, 1986, but in 1987, after 19 months, Iacocca had the marriage annulled. He married for the third time in 1991 to Darian Earle. They were divorced 3 years later. He resides in Bel Air, Los Angeles, California. Politics. Iacocca meets with President Bill Clinton on September 23, 1993. In his 2007 book Where Have All the Leaders Gone, Iacocca described how he considered running for president in 1988 and was in the planning stages of a campaign with the slogan I Like I, before ultimately being talked out of it by his friends and colleagues. Pennsylvania Governor Robert P. Casey discussed with Iacocca an appointment to the U.S. Senate in 1991 after the death of Senator H. John Hines III, but Iacocca declined politically. Iacocca supported the Republican candidate George W. Bush in the 2000 presidential election. In the 2004 presidential election, however, he endorsed Bush's opponent, Democrat John Kerry, in Michigan's 2006 gubernatorial race. Iacocca appeared in televised political ads endorsing Republican candidate Dick DeVos, who lost. Iacocca endorsed New Mexico Governor Bill Richardson for president in the 2008 presidential election. On December 3, 2007, Iacocca launched a website to encourage open dialogue about the challenges of contemporary society. He has introduced topics such as healthcare costs, and the United States' lag in developing alternative energy sources and hybrid vehicles. The site also promotes his book Where Have All the Leaders Gone? It provides an interactive means for users to rate presidential candidates by the qualities Iacocca believes they should possess: curiosity, creativity, communication, character, courage, conviction, charisma, competence, and common sense. In 2012, he endorsed Mitt Romney for President Awards. In 1985, Iacocca received the S. Roger Horcho Award for Greatest Public Service by a Private Citizen, an award given out annually by Jefferson Awards. See also United States Portal Biography, Portal Cars, Portal Ford Mustang, Iacocca Silver 45th Anniversary Edition. References. Carrot A. B. Hakim, Danny. The 19th of July 2005, Iacocca, Away from the Grind, Still Has a Lot to Say. The New York Times retrieved 17 April 2008. Carrot, After a Quarter Century, Dodge Loses Minivan Crown to Honda. Fox News January 6, 2009. Retrieved January 13, 2009. Carrot, Iacocca, Lee. 30 May 1994, I Couldn't Just Play Golf All Day. Interview with Alex Taylor Fortune. Retrieved 16 April 2012. Schlüssel Notdienst. Iacocca Foundation. Iacocca says Detroit is living in the past. National Public Radio. Lehigh University Engineering Heritage Initiative. Iacocca Biography. VEFCA US LLC. Marcus Current. Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram Fiat Automobiles USA. Defunct AMC 1966-88. Cummer 1905-79. Barreros 1959-78. DeSoto 1928-61. Eagle 1988-98. Fargo 1920-72. Hillman 1907-76. Humber 1898-1975. Imperial 1955-75, 1981-83. Carrier 1908-77. Plymouth 1928-2001. Singer 1905-70. Simca 1934-77-SRT-2013-14. Sunbeam 1901-76. Valiant 1960-66. Divisions and subsidiaries. Current Chrysler Australia. Chrysler Canada. Dodge Jeep Mopar Ram Truck Street. Current United States Council for Automotive Research. Defunct Diamond Star Motors. Daimler Chrysler Mitsubishi Alliance. Global Engine Alliance. People Walter Chrysler. Lee Iacocca. Bob Lutz. C. Robert Kidder. Thomas W. Lasorda. Sergio Marchionne. Lewis Rhodes. Places. Chrysler Building. Chrysler Headquarters and Technology Center. Factories. Proving Grounds. Products. Engines. Hemi, Pentastar, WGE. Platforms. Transmissions. Vehicles. Other Big Three. Cerberus Capital Management. Chrysler Classic Racing. Daimler Chrysler 1998-2007. History. Chapter 11. Reorganization. Parent Fiat Chrysler Automobiles. Category. Authority. Control. World. Cat. Identities. VIAF, 64,606,048. LCCN, N8210256. ISNI, 0000-0001-0909. 761XGND, 118,800,493. Sudik, 0610033. N D L 00444155.